Bakuchiol, or Bakuchiol, some people call it. Should you be using it? Is it the plant-based version of retinol? Well, I say yes. There's a study of 44 people. Well, 7 dropped out, so it's a small study, but it was shown to be equivalent to retinol in terms of clearing the skin and reducing wrinkles. Small study, but I have the benefit of seeing patients in my practice benefit from this product. Now, retinols, vitamin A derivatives, certainly they're the gold standard, but here's the problem. We know the trend for this year and next year coming is that skin care is the new makeup, meaning people want to go bare skin. That means we have to adopt a lot of what we learn from Eastern cultures, and the bocce plant is where this product comes from, and it's been used in Ayurvedic medicine and Ayurvedic skincare for many, many years. So Bakuchiol definitely plays a role in your skincare, and here's why. It decreases inflammation, whereas retinols increase inflammation. So how would you use it? You love your retinol, or maybe you can't take a retinol. There's a way to use it. If you love your retinol, you use this in between or even the same day. Now, many of you cannot take a retinol, or you can only take it once a week because you have sensitive skin, and you know you see redness, flaking, windburn feel, that if you are on it, you're going to get inflammation, loss of fat pads, thinning of the skin. So incorporating Bakuchiol into your skincare routine, into your retinol routine, would be prime, and it would help you maintain your skin, get the effects of a retinol, a vitamin A, without having one, and at the same time, decreasing that bad inflammation. So let's dive into Bakuchiol, see if it's right for you.
But what I like about it is it works through the same receptors that retinol uses, which is why many refer to it as the natural retinol alternative. I've come to know it, as I'm going to tell you, through the anti-age serum and accelerator system that I give to all my patients, because in there's no retinol. Obviously, there's growth factors and growth factor signals to signal the skin. There's no retinol, but there is Bakuchiol. And that's how I've gotten to know the ingredient. More on that in a moment. It's and why I like the fact that it's a retinol similar product, because I can have them use this through their whole facial region, including the under eye neck. And a lot of the work I do is under the eye. It's clear that these similar results for Bakuchiol are why it's giving retinol a run for its money. But what really gives Bakuchiol the edge? Well, as previously mentioned, it's natural alternative. People like that. It's not as irritating, which is great because you can use it in different areas. And it's easy for people to titrate, to figure out what to use and how to use it, because you can use it daily. It's a great option for those who shop vegan, clean, and in consideration of skin conditions like eczema, psoriasis, and dermatitis. Bakuchiol is not a vitamin A derivative, and hence that means it doesn't have that irritating ingredient. So it is indeed the vitamin A, not the fact that it's hitting the same receptors, that gives it that irritating effect, the vitamin A derivative part. So it is definitely and distinctly different in that manner. A small trial confirms the results. In a study with 44 participants, those who used retinol reported more stinging, more harsh skin texture, and more kind of a burning irritation than they did with the Bakuchiol. So it's proven to be more consistently used. But what I mean by that is less irritative and thus more consistently used. So don't discount that, because a lot of people pop off of retinols and maybe never go back, or never go back to something that hits that same receptor because of that vitamin A irritative effect. The anti-age system has many things. You put the serum on first, and then you put the accelerator. The accelerator, or that system, the accelerator and the serum combination, has niacinamide. It has peptides. Of course, human bone marrow growth factor. Not cells, not any active cells. And these are bone marrow growth factor taken from youthful people around the age of 19 to 21. And in culture, they just take a few of those cells and they culture them. But they have been tested for disease and illness. They're only the growth factor. Those are small signals that tell the skin to renew. So should you make the switch? Remember, you don't have to throw your retinol or retinoic away. You can use them at the same time in conjunction. And if you're using them both in the same day, you would use the anti-age system first. The retinol would be your last step. because I want the growth factors to be your first most absorptive after your cleansing. If you want to use them, and this is what I recommend, alternately, so you could use one day on your retinoid, the next day on your anti-aging growth factor.
You're now going to want to go to quizmd.com, and in under 5 minutes, you're going to know exactly what you should be on for your skincare, as I recommended to my patients in my clinic. And that's going to give you great insights, whether you're on my products or you're on other products. It doesn't matter. Now you're going to want to watch this video on your blueprint skincare routine, and one down here on skin thinning and fat pad loss. That's what we're trying to avoid. Stay tuned here. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.